Hi, it's Michael here in the ASP Product Training Room, and in today's video we're going to head over to the armorer side of the business, and I'm going to show you the three primary types of field service that you can perform on an ASP Baton scabbard, specifically adjusting the belt width, locking out the rotating feature of the scabbard, and adjusting the retention of the baton inside the scabbard. To perform this service, all you'll typically need is a small hex wrench, and in a moment I'll show you where you can find one in your baton scabbard, but we also have available a full scabbard repair kit that contains extra spare parts and all the tools you'll need to perform scabbard service. Let's take a closer look. The first and simplest service we can perform, and it doesn't require any tools, is adjusting the belt width. Just open the belt clip and you'll find a sliding belt width adjuster inside, and there's a variety of positions that you can slide that into to accommodate anything from a narrow dress belt or molly gear all the way up to a wide duty belt. Slide and snap it into place, close the belt clip, and you're good to go. Next, I'm going to show you how to increase or decrease the retention of the baton inside the scabbard. To do this, we'll need to remove the back plate of the scabbard, and for that we need a small hex wrench. As I mentioned a moment ago, we actually provide one for you, and it's stowed away in the back of the rotating belt clip. Easiest way to pop that out is with the double lock pin of a handcuff key or another small tool. For purposes of this video, I'm going to use the armorer's tool supplied with our scabbard kit to speed things up a little bit. It's a good idea to leave the belt clip rotated so that you have clear access to all four screws on the back plate. Go ahead and remove those four screws. Now that we have our screws removed, we can remove the back plate. Pull it out of the bottom edge first, then slide it downwards to disengage this registration tab and set the back plate aside. Inside the housing of the scabbard, you'll see a variety of parts, primarily the retention clip, which is what we're going to be adjusting in a moment. If you have an Envoy scabbard, you might see an additional cover in here, which is removable, but you can just leave it in place. And then you'll see two screws, which we'll talk about a little bit more later. There's a lockout screw and a spare. To adjust the retention of the baton inside the scabbard, you need to increase or decrease the degree to which this retention clip pushes out into the scabbard housing. So if I want to increase the retention of the baton, I simply bend a deeper curve into that. If I want to decrease it, I flatten it out. So let's go with increase. I'm going to put a pretty deep curve into that. And then I'm going to put that back in place, making sure to locate that registration pin in the hole. And then I'm going to temporarily fit the back plate back in position and hold it so that I can try the baton inside the scabbard and see if I'm happy with the retention. If you want to fine tune it, you just open it back up again and again increase or decrease that curve. Once you've got that set, you can just fasten the back plate back in place. And here's where you might want to know about this black screw here. That's a spare. If you lose any of these four back plate screws, you have a replacement handy right there. The last thing that we can do is to lock out the rotation of the belt clip so that we fix our baton scabbard in a vertical position. We do that while we have the case open. And this is where we're going to use this gold-colored screw with the lock washer attached to it. Take that screw out of its little storage compartment. Go back to your belt clip side of the back plate, and you're going to see this little lockout hole right here. Put the screw in there, tighten it down, and it's perfectly normal to feel a little resistance as the screw works its way into the back plate, and now you've got that locked out. Then follow the steps to, again, reattach the back plate to the scabbard. Now, once the belt clip is permanently aligned in the vertical position, you're going to need to open it to access these top two holes. And then you can go ahead and finish the reassembly of your scabbard. So that's all you need to know about how to service your ASP Baton scabbard. You can find many other videos about product and armorer service tips on the video section of our website at asp-usa.com. Thanks for your time.